This is Yurakucho Station on the Tokyo Metro Yurakucho Line. The Yurakucho Line runs diagonally through central Tokyo, from the northwest to the southeast. It plays a key role in the network, offering numerous through services with other railway operators. I'm heading to the next stop, Sakuradamon Station. Though only about 2 minutes away, this station is also located in the very heart of the city. At Sakuradamon Station, however, there are no transfers to other lines. Access routes to the ticket gates are located at both ends of the platform. I step down onto the platform. Unlike Yurakucho Station, there are hardly any people here, despite the early hour. The platform curves gently to the right toward the far end. There is a waiting room for platform staff here, but no one is present yet. The opposite end also curves to the right, giving the station as a whole an S-shaped layout. This station opened in 1974, roughly 50 years ago. Its interior reflects the typical design of stations built by the Teito Rapid Transit Authority, the predecessor of Tokyo Metro. In stations where platforms are sandwiched between tracks, the platform usually narrows at both ends, but this station differs. Here, the tunnel housing the tracks also drops lower, creating several unusual structural features. The platform extends just over one car length beyond the stairs, with an elevator located at the far end. The newer interior finishes and the single uniquely shaped pillar suggest this section was added later. Beyond the platform lies a circular tunnel sloping downward toward the rear. Let's head toward the ticket gates. The escalator is unexpectedly long, even though it does not pass beneath any other lines. On this side, there are three exits, numbered 3 through 5. Of exits 4 and 5 on the right, only exit 4 has an elevator to street level. Exposed piping along the ceiling stands out, though the passageway itself feels spacious. I'm heading instead for exit 3 on the left. This corridor is narrower and feels noticeably darker. Further ahead, it curves again, tightening before bending gently to the left. Looking up from here, there are no buildings in sight above the entrance, not even overhead power lines. Behind and to the right stands a building, immediately adjacent to a wide, multi-lane road, but this accounts for only about half the station's surroundings. Further to the right, a large pond and forest come into view. This is the Imperial Palace, a place often mentioned in station announcements and signage. The Yurakucho Line runs through central Tokyo, skirting the southern edge of the Imperial Palace. The station area lies beneath the roadway and was constructed using the open-cut method, excavated from the surface, while the remainder of the line consists of shield tunnels extending toward the neighboring stations. Shield tunneling involves advancing a circular machine fitted with a cutting head, then assembling concrete segments from within to form the tunnel. Compared with open-cut construction, the shield method minimizes surface impact, except when the machine is launched or retrieved. However, tunneling beneath the Imperial Palace moat reportedly required delicate coordination with the Outer Gardens Administration. North of the station lies the Imperial Palace, to the west the National Diet Building and its forecourt, and a short distance east is Hibiya Park. With few attractions that draw crowds, the station primarily serves destinations to its south. And these destinations are more than just ordinary buildings. Rising behind and to the left of where I emerged earlier is the Tokyo Metropolitan Police Department. Sakuradamon is also a nickname for the Metropolitan Police Department, and Exit 4, equipped with an elevator, is the closest to it. The area is home to courts and government offices, and the surrounding area map is filled with facilities that live up to their formal names. With many major lines converging nearby, including Kasumigaseki Station, itself synonymous with government offices, Sakuradamon Station is actually quite convenient for non-Yurakucho Line users. Last year, Sakuradamon Station recorded an average daily ridership of just over 13,000 passengers. Kasumigaseki Station, where three lines converge, saw over 132,000 passengers per day, less than one-third per line. This places Sakuradamon as the second least used station on the Tokyo Metro network. Even on weekday mornings, the station remains quiet. But being adjacent to the Imperial Palace, the ticket gate I used is named the Imperial Palace Gate, and a similar notice appears on the reverse side of a sign in the corridor. However, this station has another side. The ticket gate on the west side is named after the National Diet Building. Kokai Gijidoma Station is nearby, but exit 2, the closest to the main gate, lies on the southern side of the grounds, making Sakuradamon's exit 2 nearly the same distance. I head back underground toward the western side of the station. Skipping past the otherwise unremarkable platform, I reach the opposite side, where an upward escalator and staircase are arranged one behind the other. This configuration exists because the platform here is too narrow to place stairs and escalators side by side. Looking at the map above, the road appears wide and spacious. So why is this the case? This ticket gate operates from 6 a.m. to 11 p.m. It is closed for the first and last trains, and there are currently no staff present.
I step outside the gate. The silence is so complete that the sound of ticket punches echoes clearly. I turn right toward exit 1. The ground rises on this side, and with the surface level higher, the climb takes some time. Neither of the two entrances facing the Imperial Palace has a roof. This is how it appears at ground level. This entrance stands 9.6 meters above sea level. The previous entrance was at 6.8 meters, a difference of 2.8 meters, making it feel as though you're looking down into the palace moat. Beyond runners and cyclists circling the palace grounds, the National Diet Building comes into view. Meanwhile, exit 2, located to the left after passing through the gate, features an escalator partway up. Because it is wide and close to government offices, the station's northern and southern sides offer very different environments. Exit 2 sits on former Metropolitan Police Department land, and discussions are currently underway regarding its installation. It is the most imposing of the five entrances, and its distinction is immediately apparent. The intersection to the right is fittingly named the National Diet. Police officers maintain a visible presence throughout the area. As shown on the station map, it's possible to move between the two ticket gates without passing through the platform. Proceed through the passage to the left of the Imperial Palace Gate. The ceiling lowers here because the rear section is a two-level structure, platform and concourse, while the front includes a third level housing machinery and other facilities. This explains why earlier, the tunnel above the tracks was lower at the end of the platform. On the opposite side, the structure remains two levels, so the tunnel height stays constant. The elevators at the Imperial Palace Gate are labeled Basement 1 and Basement 3, hinting at an additional intermediate level. This is where the Sakuradamon Control Center once stood, overseeing operations for the Yurakucho and Hanzomon lines. In 1994, it was relocated to the General Control Center at the Marunouchi Line's Koishikawa Depot and subsequently closed. Next door is a meeting room known as the Sakuradamon Special Conference Room. Situated between the Imperial Palace and the Metropolitan Police Department, it features a distinctly mysterious ventilation structure. At the very back, a former ventilation room has been converted into sleeping quarters for train crews. Trains are stored here overnight and dispatched to neighboring Yurakucho Station the next morning to operate the first service. At first glance, the station seems plain and unremarkable, but it holds another hidden side. Here's a view from the rear of a train bound for Nagatacho. Tracks branch off to the left and exit to the right. Looking closely at the junction, you can see that while access to the right-hand tracks is physically possible, trains cannot actually proceed along that route. These tracks terminate at Kasumigase Station on the Chiyoda Line, which appeared earlier in the story. The tunnel measures 578 meters in length, with nearly its entire stretch forming a curve of 167 meters radius. Though constructed as a shield tunnel like those before and after Sakuradamon, the tight curvature required a compact 5.1 meter long mini tunneling machine. The narrow platform width on the Nagatacho side is believed to result from the presence of a connecting track positioned directly beside the station, allowing the tunnel to diverge quickly from the Yurakucho line. From the right side here, you can get a clear view down the tunnel.
Notice how, because the tracks merge, the cant cannot be applied as strongly as on adjacent curves, making the cars appear less stable. This track exists to connect the Chiyoda and Yurakucho lines, so direct movement between the inbound and outbound Yurakucho tracks is not possible here. And there is an important reason this tunnel was built to link the two lines. When the Yurakucho line first opened between Ikebukuro and Ginza Ichome, it lacked facilities for major rolling stock maintenance, prompting the construction of a tunnel to allow access to the ISA workshop near Kita ISA Station on the Chiyoda line. A tunnel was therefore built to enable use of the ISA workshop on the Chiyoda line. Fortunately, both lines share the same track gauge and overhead power standards, allowing trains to pass through directly. In fact, when the line first opened, rolling stock was delivered via this very route. This tunnel crosses beneath the Marunouchi line once, and the Shuto Expressway twice, demanding enormous effort and expense, but without it, trains would have required impractical overland transport. Today, the track is used only for non-revenue movements, but it once carried a passenger service from the Odakyu line through to Shinkiba, the Yurakucho line's terminus. That train was the Bay Resort, which continued on to the JR Keio line to serve demand for Tokyo Disneyland. Using Odakyu's luxurious 60,000 series MSE Limited Express cars, the service suffered from slow speeds due to the inability to overtake on Tokyo Metro lines, and it was discontinued after operating from 2008 to 2011. At the time, platform screen doors were planned for the Yurakucho line, but unlike today, accommodating different door positions was uncommon, possibly contributing to the service's cancellation. Even now, more than a decade later, markers indicating the former stopping positions remain on the wall. While the Bay Resort is gone, the Odakyu Romance Car continues to operate on the Chiyoda line.
And this is not the only connecting track of its kind. Another can be found at Ichigaya Station, three stops away. From the rear of the train, the tracks approach from the right as it departs, intersect, and then diverge to the left. I step off the platform and head to the spot mentioned earlier. Look closely, and you'll notice the tunnel junction overlaps with the platform itself, rather than sitting beyond the station. It isn't fully walled either. On the right, the wall disappears, leaving only columns and a clear view beyond. There's even an opening in part of the tunnel wall, exposing the tracks behind. The tracks at the back appear miniature, but that's because they descend further as they extend. And posted on the wall is the following explanation. Oji is also a station on the Namboku Line, which connects here. Beneath the Imperial Palace moat, 22 years after the Yurakucho Line station opened in October 1974, the Namboku Line station was built in 1996, and a connecting track was added to allow Namboku Line rolling stock to be serviced at ISA. Because the tracks were constructed later, they slightly encroached on the platform due to the original siding beside the station, requiring the sidewall to be removed. At that time, the stopping position for Kebukuro-bound trains was shifted several meters, narrowly clearing the connecting track. And there's more here than just the connection. Additional tracks between the two lines serve as storage sidings. There's also a turnaround track alongside the main line, allowing smooth operations to and from Akabana Iwabuchi on the Namboku line. From inside a Namboku line train, the tunnel extending far to the right and the adjacent sidings are clearly visible. Unfortunately, the section linking to the Yurakucho line cannot be seen. Because it spans both lines, overhead power and maintenance zones are clearly divided, and the boundary is visible from the Yurakucho line platform where it branches from the sidings.
Is this board used during transfers? Incidentally, these are the tracks located between the inbound and outbound lines near Ichigaya Station on the Yurakucho line. They merge further ahead into a single track and continue onward. This facility was created to allow basic maintenance when the line opened, and although access was via Ichigaya Station, it was named the Itabashi Inspection Yard after nearby Itabashi Station. Today, the Yurakucho line operates only 10-car trains, but when the yard opened, services were 5 cars long, and the facility could hold 6 trains, 30 cars in total. This is why the inbound and outbound Yurakucho line tracks never merge after leaving Ichigaya Station. In addition to washing and inspection facilities, the site once included a crew base. But as the line expanded, a full-scale depot was built elsewhere, and its role came to an end. The connecting track between the Yurakucho and Namboku lines is now mostly used by out-of-service trains, though it once carried services such as the Bay Resort and special trains for the Tokyo Bay Fireworks Festival. It supported not only services linking the Chiyoda, Yurakucho, and Namboku lines, but also special trains from the Tokyo Toyoko line, which at the time had no direct Namboku line connection. This press release dates back to 2006. The Tokyo Bay Fireworks Festival has since been discontinued, as the surrounding area was redeveloped into the Olympic Athletes Village, and these special trains no longer operate. Meanwhile, the Namboku line is also connected to the Hanzamon line via Toki's through services, and Hanzamon line trains are routed via a connecting line to the Yurakucho line's Shinkiba Depot for refurbishment. The Yurakucho line also links with the Fukushima line, meaning 5 of Tokyo Metro's 9 lines are interconnected through these routes. Such connecting tracks are common in cities with multiple compatible railway lines, and similar examples can be found elsewhere in Japan. Thank you for watching.